I'm Harris Duininck, and with my cousin Griffin, we're about to dive headfirst into the family trade.
We're taking you behind the scenes of the water management business as we learn from the pros.
Join us on our road trip across the U.S. as we explore this fascinating industry.
We're learning a little bit about resiliency in the plastic pipe industry. Gonna tour a job site. We're excited to learn and learn more about resiliency.
So this is our yard. This is where we store everything, bring everything in, load it, take it out to the contractors, cities, municipalities.
So tomorrow we're gonna see a chamber job. Tell us a little bit about chambers.
These arch things here, they're basically for underground water storage. So instead of having a big detention pond, you have parking lot.
Yeah.
You know, so it's awesome. It is awesome. Metal's three times as much, concrete's three times as much. So very cost efficient.
It's genius.
That's kind of the theme of our summer is resiliency.
Yeah.
And why plastics are more resilient than concrete and other products that water can, you know, have a place to go and not have to waste a bunch of land. It's something that, you know, as young people we think about. We're kind of looking into our business careers coming up in the next few years. What is some advice or excitement about the plastic industry?
Well, I would tell you guys that there's always going to be infrastructure that needs to be put in. What we do, what we sell here, it's not going away. So if you're asking me what you guys need to do, relationship, relationship, relationship. Know your people, your customers, your vendors, your employees, know who they are.
Thanks for the advice. It's been meaningful being here. Yeah. Appreciate it.
Thank you guys very much. Thank you.
Matt Walter from Prinsco, he's gonna tell us a little bit about the Go Car Wash project. What's going on here, Matt?
Land is very expensive. So what they do with the detention system, whether it's our pipe or our chamber systems, is they put it underground, usually under the parking lot, and that way they're using every bit of the property on the site. Within our chamber system, there is also a water quality aspect. We call it our sediment row, you know, which cleans the parking lot of oil, debris, trash.
The chamber system itself is one, going to store water back, and it's also going to somewhat keep the water clean or cleaner than when it goes into the stream after the fact. This first row is going to take all the sand, the silt, oil from vehicles,
cigarette butts,
all the trash, and it's going to stay in this row, and as the water filters over into the neighboring rows before it leaves, it is going to be now a kind of a cleaner water. So all of the storm boxes that are on this site, storm boxes being the spots in the curb that you see or a grate in the middle of the driveway where rainwater can run into, all of the boxes on this site are gonna first enter into the chamber system. The whole point, instead of just having your boxes dumped straight into the stream, is for flooding. And you can now store water back and slowly allow it to seep back into the creek, having cleaner water leaving the job site before it goes into your streams and rivers.
This would be kind of a replacement for like a pond.
Your pond is now underground with pavement over the top. So in this case, it's additional parking.
That makes sense. I mean, in growing cities, I mean, there's a need for land and it's getting expensive.
With having the pond system now underground, you can have more customers and less of a headache and maintenance. It's a system self-contained in its own right.
So how long does a system like this last for?
It being a plastic system that requires no maintenance and is buried underground, I would say as long as any other plastic pipe that's in ground is currently good for. Your new water mains are all plastic. Your sanitary sewer mains are all plastic. So with it being plastic, there's no chance for rust. Like the old metal systems, I don't see that these could ever fail.
I've definitely learned a lot.
I agree. Looking forward to the rest of the summer. We got a couple more trips and intrigued with the industry and what's going on.